Hey guys, welcome back. Jordan here with the Nutty Gnome Homestead. It is late February 2024, and we are getting ready to make bacon. Now, today we're actually going to be making buckboard bacon, but the process is the same whether I'm using pork bellies, pork shoulder, or pork loin. So, I have used pork bellies in the past, but they're getting a little too expensive. The pork loins, they're getting up there in price as well whenever we make our Canadian bacon. I like my bacon pretty lean. So we usually lean towards either the pork shoulder or the pork loin. Today we're going to be making buckboard bacon out of a pork shoulder. I ended up with about 31 pounds, 30 and a half, 31 pounds of pork shoulders, and I have already deboned them, and what I'm going to do now is I'm going to weigh them and get them set aside so I can add the cure. Now I'm going to let these cure for about 7 to 10 days, depending on the thickness, when I have time. And then about a week, 10 days or so from now, we will take them out, finish processing them, and get them in the smoker. This is a cheap and easy way to make your own bacon at home, especially with the price of bacon in the store pushing $6, $7, $8 a pound. This usually comes out pretty cheap. Biggest expense is the meat itself. So I'm going to get you guys turned around here, and I'm going to show you how we make bacon on the Nutty Gnome Homestead. Okay guys, so what you see here is a pork shoulder that weighs about 10 pounds. I've already taken out the bone, and I've went on ahead and cut it into two more manageable pieces. This is going to make it easier for the cure to penetrate within that 7 to 10 day time frame that I'm shooting for, and it's also going to make these easier to fit into a bag and handle in the refrigerator. So what we're going to be doing here is we're going to be using some of our homemade bacon cure. Now this is just a mixture of sugar, kosher salt, coarse kosher salt, and prog powder number one, or pink curing salt. Here's some of the pink curing salt. Don't get this confused with Himalayan pink salt. This stuff can hurt you if you ingest too much of it. I like to mix up a bulk batch of our curing salt, of our cure for our bacon. This is the same cure that I put on my Canadian bacon, that I put on my buckboard bacon or pork bellies. It's all the same. Like I said, it's just a mixture of coarse kosher salt, sugar, and the pink salt number one, prog powder number one, cure number one. You want to make sure you get the cure number one, because the number two is for the long drying curing times. Cure number one is for the short curing times. I have already weighed out both pieces of meat here, and I know one of them is approximately 1,870 grams and the other one is 2,072 grams. We want to weigh and measure everything in grams because that makes everything a lot more accurate whenever it comes to mixing up our cure. Okay, so I got everything set up now. I know this first piece of meat that I've already cut and trimmed up the way I want it is going to take 46.7 grams of our homemade curing salt. So all we're going to do is we're going to measure it out into this bowl. And like I said, you want to measure in grams to be as accurate as you can. Okay. Now all we're going to do is we are going to transfer this first piece of meat onto another pan. Now, I told you I trimmed these up. Whenever I got this, it had a real thick fat cap on here. I trimmed that down to about a quarter inch thick. I don't like bacon that has a real thick fat cap on it. And I'm also getting ready to make sausage next week, so none of the trimmings go to waste. It goes right into our sausage bin. So we're just going to evenly distribute this bacon cure. We're going to rub it in. You want to make sure you get in between any of the folds. You want to make sure you have really good coverage on this. Turn it over, distribute the other side. Make sure you get the ends. Now, these pieces are going to be separated further after they are cured before we put them in the smoker. I'm leaving them like this because they're going to fit into the refrigerator a lot easier for us this way. Now, at this time, you could actually leave this the way it is. However, I like to kick things up a notch. We're going to add some black pepper. You could add molasses, maple syrup, brown sugar. You can add whatever you want. Make sure you get it all over. Now, folks, this is in no way an in-depth tutorial. This is just quick and dirty how we do it. How we make our bacon here on the farm. We've been doing it this way for 10, 12 years or so. Get a good layer of pepper on there. Whenever we add brown sugar, I like to add 2 tablespoons per side. So usually about 4 tablespoons for the whole piece of meat total. You can always add more, but I don't want it to be too overpowering. Now, we're going to take this and we're going to put it in a Ziploc bag. And we're going to set it aside in the freezer, in the refrigerator for 7 to 10 days. I'm going to go ahead and get the other one done now. Okay, so I got this one all done up. I'll put any of this extra cure on this piece of meat, anything that fell off the pan. You want to make sure you got everything on there nice and evenly coated. Now, like I said, these are going to go into our refrigerator for about 7 to 10 days. So I have 6 1-gallon bags of pork shoulder here that I've already added this cure to. In total, we had 28 pounds out of that original 30 and a half, 31 pounds of pork shoulders. We are going to lose a lot of our weight total whenever this goes through the cure. That salt's going to draw a lot of that moisture out of the meat. It's going to be a little bit smaller whenever we take it out. This is going to go in the refrigerator for about 7 to 10 days. We're going to try to turn this over at least once a day. We want to make sure to massage the packages. If we see the plastic sticking to the meat anywhere, we're going to massage it and make sure that the cure is evenly distributed all the way around. This is going to ensure that you get a nice, even cure, and you're not going to have any spots of the pork shoulder that didn't get anything that could potentially harbor bacteria later. After about 7 to 10 days, we're going to pull this out. We're going to wash off the remaining cure on the outside. We're going to give it some time to dry. This is going to allow a pedicle to form, which is a little layer of protein. It kind of gets a glaucous white coating on it. And then we're going to stick it in our smoker. We harvest our wood right here off of our farm. This is what we're going to be smoking with. We make somewhere around 100 pounds of bacon annually. And this is the same process we use whether we're using pork bellies, pork shoulder, or pork loins. So I will bring you guys back later on whenever it's time to throw these in the smoker. I appreciate you guys coming along. And if you have any questions about making bacon at home, please feel free to shoot me a message down below or contact us over on Nutty Gnome Homestead on Facebook. Till next time, get out there and make your bacon, guys. It's a lot easier than you think, and it tastes so much better than what you get at the store.